This
Yes.
conference will
Conmigo
now be
deriva la emoción.
recorded.
So we know the value of carbohydrates, important biomolecules in our body cells. So we have to study its structure and also function. Carbohydrates are the most abundant organic constituents of plants and also our living tissues. Okay. So we know very well about our photosynthesis. Okay. So they serve as the major source of chemical energy for living organisms, sugar and starch. Yes, we can get through our photosynthesis in plants, and when we take, automatically we can get carbohydrate. It is important energy compound. Next. Carbohydrates, based on the structure, we can classify the carbohydrates into polyhydroxyaldehydes and ketones, or substances that hydrolyze to yield polyhydroxyaldehydes and ketones. Okay, so when we dissolve the carbohydrate compounds, water molecule, we can get more amount of polyhydroxyaldehyde and also polyhydroxyketones. Okay. So many hydroxyl group which is present in it. And in if you take any sugar in the sense, more hydrogen atoms are there, more hydroxyl atom, hydroxyl compound are there, and also a primary alcohol should be there, and automatically functional compound, either aldehyde or ketone must be present in it. Okay, so that is the carbohydrate structure. So we can classify the carbohydrates based on its structure into monosaccharide, disaccharide, oligosaccharide and also polysaccharide. We know that, and also we are going to study in detail about the structure and also function of our carbohydrates. Okay, so and also in the definition we can define carbohydrate. Okay, hydroxyl carbons, hydrated carbons, CHO, CNH2ON. Okay, so more number of carbon, C6H12O6. If you take in the example of glucose, C6H12O6. That means C and also H, CH2O. C and oxygen are same, the numbers, and hydrogen double. Next. My signal is weak here. I'm sorry. Okay, next slide, Shivam. Classification. So I already told you, based on the number of saccharides present in the compounds, we can classify the carbohydrates into monosaccharide, disaccharide, oligosaccharide, and also polysaccharide. I told you, no. Okay, so saccharide means sugar. Okay, so monosaccharide, only one sugar is there, right? So monosaccharide, one sugar, and two disaccharides, when two sugars are joined together, and oligosaccharide, 3 to 10 saccharides are there, and poly more than 10. Okay, so monosaccharide, disaccharide, oligosaccharide are based on its structure we can classify, you know. Okay, so we have to focus on what is monosaccharide. Monosaccharide. Next. Yes, it's a simple carbohydrate. Okay, so when we are going for hydrolysis, so in this process we can get only one sugar. I mean, it is not be hydrolyzed further, it not be hydrolyzed. Okay, that there is only one sugar only there. If we hydrolyze, we can get two saccharides in the things, that is called as disaccharide. Okay, so on hydrolysis, if we get two more, I mean 3 to 9 saccharides in the sense, that is called as oligosaccharide. Next. So next, monosaccharide. So I already told you, so further we could not be hydrolyzed. Okay, that sugars are called as monosaccharide. saccharides, saccharin, okay, sweet in taste. Next. Monosaccharides. So the number of carbon atoms present in the molecule, whether they contain an aldehyde or ketone group. Yes, I already told you people, if you take sugars, sugar, any one sugar, in the sense, you can get primary alcohol. My primary alcohol is must. Okay. One primary alcohol group is there, and so many hydrogen atoms and so many hydroxyl groups, and also one primary alcohol I already mentioned. So the remaining one is either aldehyde or ketone group must be there as a functional group. Okay, so based on that we can name the sugars into aldo sugar, keto sugar like. Okay, so if sugar containing its compound as aldehyde, in the sense that is called as aldo sugar. Okay, so no, if the sugar contain only ketone group, ma'am, okay, that is called as keto sugar. So based on the number of carbon present in the compound, we can classify the sugar into diose, triose, tetrose, pentose, aldose, hexose, heptose, cellulose, like we can do the name into that saccharides. Okay, so glycolaldehyde is there, right? So if you write the structure, important compounds present in the sugar is, okay, I mean, for example, only two carbon is there, because glycolaldehyde, no, only two carbon is there. So CHO and CH2H, okay, CHO and CH2H present in that structure, so that is glycolaldehyde. So glyceraldehyde, three carbons are there, and four carbon, five carbon, okay, so that five carbons, six carbons, seven carbons, all those carbons in its head and also tail contains one functional group and also one primary alcohol. Okay, and in that intermediate, rest of the compounds, I mean that first carbon and also if you take a pentose sugar, in the sense, five carbons are there, no, first carbon contain one functional group, fifth carbon contains a primary alcohol, and the rest of the three carbon contains a hydrogen and also hydroxyl group. Okay, so like that structure of our monosaccharides are present. And at the same time, triose sugar, okay, take one triose sugar, that is a glyceraldehyde. Okay, so glyceraldehyde, aldo triose, okay, aldo triose, why we can give the name, the functional compound present in glyceraldehyde is aldehyde. Okay, number of carbon is three, so that is aldo triose. Okay, aldo tetrose, take the same four carbons and the functional group is aldehyde. Okay, at the same, keto triose, in the sense, three carbon compound containing the functional group is ketone. Okay, so like that we can give the name to the structure of our monosaccharides, aldo triose, keto triose, aldo pentose, keto pentose like. Okay, next. Come, please, next. Yes, you see here, CH2H, primary alcohol. Okay, so the CHOHN, okay, N number. Okay, that is four number or five number based on the number of carbon. Okay, pentose sugar or hexose sugar, what we people can take. So based on it, okay. So for example, if it is hexose sugar, in the sense, six carbon containing sugar. Okay, so the first carbon. So you see this. See this yellow color is aldehyde compound functional group. Okay, functional group for this compound is aldehyde. Okay, so the next, I told you, no, first carbon aldehyde or ketone, so the last carbon primary alcohol. So in between, so many hydrogen, so many hydroxyl group, okay, which are present there, right? So this is aldose, aldo sugar. Okay, so see this ketone. Okay, so ketone is the functional group for this sugar, so this is called as keto sugar. So but two primary alcohols are there because of to balance the valency, right? Next, see here, aldehyde group functional compound and the primary alcohol is there and in between. Okay, so how many carbons are there? Four. Okay, so this is called as tetrose. The functional compound is aldehyde, so aldo tetrose. Okay, see here, keto pentose, five carbons are there, so keto pentose. Okay, next. and L designations of monosaccharide. Okay, so that is easy. Based on the Kliani synthesis, I told you. Okay, up to that, I told all those informations. No? That is based on the Kliani synthesis. Okay, so from the 2 to 3, 3 to 4 carbon compound sugars, 5 carbon containing sugars, and 6. So I mean glycolaldehyde, 2 compound, 3 compounds, glyceraldehyde, 4 tetrose and also erythrose, 5 means xylose, arabinose and ribose, like lyose, like four sugars are there. Okay, so in that pentose sugar. So hexose sugar, if you take mannose and talose, glucose, glose, mannose, I already told you, allose, altrose, like so many compounds are there in hexose sugar. Okay, I mean we are talking about monosaccharides. Based on the number of carbons, we can give the name to the monosaccharide into diose, triose, tetrose, pentose, and also hexose. Okay. So after that, we people discuss in the sense how we can give the common name to that sugars, like aldotriose, aldopentose, ketotriose, ketopentose, based on the number of carbon and also based on the compounds present there, we can give the name, right? So after that, okay, so we come to that based on the structure, we can classify the monosaccharides into D sugar and also L sugar, like no. So how? Because if you are working in your laboratory, you can see the name for a particular glucose box, like D glucose, L galactose, like. So what do you mean by D and also L? Dextro and also levo. Based on the rotation, we can give the name, the sugar, I mean the word to dextro, that is right side, levo, left side. Okay, so clockwise and also anti-clockwise, it will rotate, right? So when a beam, I mean polarized beam light, when we people pause on the solution containing our sugar. Okay, you take one beaker and fill up by water and pour some sugar. Okay, that is maybe glucose or fructose or whatever it may be, right? So you dissolve well, automatically it will get dissolved, right? So at the time, if we pass beam polarized light on the solution, okay, so the molecules which are present, that means the glucose molecule and fructose molecule, that sugar containing the molecules, no, it will get rotated. Okay, so if it rotates on the right side, means that is called as D. Okay, if it rotates on the left, means that is called as L sugar. Okay, so see here, glyceraldehyde, right? So plus and also minus in the sense dextro and also levo, right? It's rotation based on the right side, rotation based on the left side. Okay, so next Shivam. Okay, so here also the same content, monosaccharide whose highest numbered stereocenter has the same configuration, I mean the glyceraldehyde designator, the sugar. Okay, next. Sure. So they I mean previous slide they mentioned the optical. Okay, can we use the light? So we can use the term optical, so optical rotation. Okay, structure formula, monosaccharides, Fischer projection and also Haworth formulas. So this is open chain. Okay, see this, what is this?
Like that.
So functional compound is aldehyde. Okay, so primary alcohol, it may be present there. Okay, it must be present there in every sugar, right? So in between, so many hydrogen atoms, I already told you, no? Hydrogen. Okay, and hydroxyl group, you see here hydroxyl. Okay, done, right? So how I can tell this is glucose? Okay, when I see the sugar, I told you this is glucose. Okay, instead of the CHO, you just imagine here CHOH. Okay, in the second carbon, C double bond O. Okay, but the hydroxyl group in the left side, third carbon containing the left side hydroxyl group only there. Okay, hydrogen is there. Hydrogen here also same. Hydroxyl same. Hydrogen same. Hydroxyl same. Okay, everything is same. But I asked you people to imagine the first, second carbon only as First carbon, CH2OH, like same. What is here? Primary alcohol, like the same you have to imagine. Here also CH2OH. Okay. So, but I left. CHO is not there. Okay. So, instead of CHO, we know very well. If a sugar in the sense, it must be contained as a functional group of aldehyde, either aldehyde or ketone. Okay. I asked you people to lift a CHO. Okay. And the sugar must be contained. C double bond O, no? Ketone sugar, no? Yes. So where you have to write? You have to write in the second carbon. Okay, because always ketone into balance the balancing. We have to write the C double bond O in this second carbon only, no? Okay. So here in the second carbon, C double bond O. This sugar. Okay. Here CH2OH. Second carbon, C double bond O. Others are same. Okay, rest of the compounds are same, is called as fructose. Okay, how can I tell? Yes, so many instruments we have to use, okay, to find out all the hydroxyl group, hydrogen group, CHO and CH2OH, okay, where it is present and how many hydrogen hydroxyl groups are present, okay, chromatography and the spectrometer. And other instruments are there. No, so many instruments are there. Okay, by using the separation techniques and also determinant. Okay, to find out our structural determination, X-ray crystallography are there. X-ray crystallography and also NMR are there. Okay, by using all those instruments, we can find out the structure. Okay, so after found the structure, we can give which sugar is this. Okay, so I told you, know the position of the compounds. Okay, so if the compounds present like here, okay, what mentioned here, like the same, if it positioned means that is called as glucose. Okay, so here they took glucose, right? Okay, open chain. So this is okay. Havard uses the cycle structure. Okay, we can mention the boat like structure also, char like structure, boat like structure. Okay, so how we can write this structure? Okay, so we already mentioned in our first class, not only in our first class, you people all very clever and intelligent people. Okay, this generation people, when compared to last generation people, you have the power, mental power of 10 times you people greater than us. Okay, this generation, right? So what am I telling you? Chemistry is very basic for our biochemistry, right? So we people are very clear in our bond, link, what is the reaction behind there, okay, when the compounds are mixed, when the new compound is formed, okay, so everything we should know. Okay, so polymer, we are talking about these saccharides or joined together, like we people are talking about. So here I'm asking you people commonly, okay, protein is the polymer, yes, nucleic acid is the polymer. Our carbohydrate polysaccharide is the polymer. Okay, monosaccharide is not a polymer. Polysaccharide is the polymer. Right. So, when a polymer is formed, so many bonds, molecules are joined together through bond. Then after that only we can get polymer, no? Right. So, for nucleic acid, the bond. For the protein is the bond. Okay, to make the polymer, what are the bonds are there to join the molecules? Okay, so here the bond is glycosidic linkage. Glycosidic linkage. Okay, so one hydrogen atom and also one hydroxyl atom will be removed. Okay, when they get removed, automatically the rest of the molecules will be joined. Okay, so to write this Havard formula, the glycosidic linkage is very important. So see here, so the oxygen, right? So the electrons shift from here to the fifth carbon. Okay, the electrons shift in from the first carbon into fifth carbon. Okay, so here we can get the cycle form, right? See here, this is first carbon here, right side. See this, this is cycle, no? So in this cycle, दिस इज फर्स्ट फर्स्ट कार्बन, दिस इज सेकेंड कार्बन, थर्ड कार्बन, फोर्थ कार्बन, ओके, फर्स्ट सेकेंड थर्ड फिफ्थ, ओके, तो दिस इज पाइरोनोस और फ्यूरोनोस, दिस इज फ्यूरोनोस बिकॉज फाइव कॉम्पाउंड्स ओनली आर देयर, ओके, तो वेट आई विल शो यू, प्लीज नेक्स्ट. Projection. You see, I will show you pyranose and furanose. Shivam, please go to the next slide. Pyranose and furanose form, they will do only that simple ring. No, go. Go forward. They will mention pyranose and furanose. You just show to the students. No, Shivam, please go. Pyranose and furanose. Common cycle structure, we will show them. Next, 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 next. Yeah, wait. So see, my dear students. So see, this is pyran, this is furan. Okay, pyranose, six carbon membered ring structure. This one. Okay, this is five carbon membered. Okay, so this is called as pyranose and also furanose. Okay, so if you write arabinose, for ribose, for xylose, for lyose, okay, for these pento sugars, okay, I mentioned these four sugars, no, what are the sugars? Arabinose, ribose, and also lyose, xylose, okay. So if I ask you people to draw the structure for these pento sugar, in the sense, you have to draw like this, you have to use this membered ring structure. Okay, so if I ask you people to draw the structure for hexose, in the sense, you have to use this cycle membered. Okay, so this is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the sixth carbon must be there. Okay, right. So fifth, first, and also fifth carbon joined together through this oxygen atom. Okay, so this is sixth carbon membered ring, that is hexose sugar. For hexose sugar, we have to use this kind of cycle, so that is pyranose. Okay, so furanose, in the sense, you don't forget, in the cycle we have to use five carbon. Okay, so outside of the cycle we have to use the final carbon. Okay, if it is seven carbon, six carbon, five carbon, like sugars are there, no. Okay, so this is I asked you people to draw the structure for hexose sugar, no. Okay, so in this compound you have to mention only five carbon. Okay, sixth carbon must be there. Okay, with the fifth carbon, it is there in the sixth carbon. Okay, so this is five carbon ring structure, no. So here first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, and fifth carbon, it is connected with this fourth and present in the outside. Okay, it won't come into that cycle. Okay, so right, next, what I come to say, we know very well about our nucleic acid. Okay, so nucleic acid, in the sense of DNA, RNA are very important, you know. Okay, so in this nucleic acid, our ribose sugar is very important. Why? Because see the name itself, deoxyribonucleic acid, and also ribonucleic acid. Okay. So whether you are going to study about DNA or whether you are going to study about RNA, okay, the base is, I mean, the basic information is deoxyribo, okay. That means from the ribose sugar, if you remove one oxygen, in the sense, from the second carbon, that is called as deoxyribo sugar. Okay, so like that, ribose sugar, in the sense, no need to change our ribose structure. Okay, no changes in ribose structure, so that is called as RNA, ribonucleic acid. Okay, so how you people draw, this is the structure is important. Okay, this one, that is furan, because that is five membered ring structure, our ribose, so we have to use this furan. Okay, you people this is a familiar structure, no? Okay, because the DNA is very important for our life science students, no? So you can repeatedly see this structure. Okay, yes. Let's go back to Shivam. Is this we have to continue? Is this our last slide? I'm not sure. Okay. D and L isomers of monosaccharides. Okay, this is Fisher projection is in open chain form. Okay, Haworth in cycle form. Don't forget this. Fisher's in this chain. Okay, that Haworth in cycle. Right. So you see this 1, 2, 3. Three carbons are there, no? Disaldehyde. Okay. How we can give the disaldehyde name into L and also D based on its rotation. Okay. So hydroxyl group which is present in the left side. Okay. So this is L because it is in the rotation of left side. So see here. Okay. If you write the hydroxyl group in the right side, so that is the rotation if it is caused in the right, okay, right side movement. So this is right. D form is clockwise, L form anticlockwise. Okay, negative. If you people have any doubt in the sense, you can ask me. Okay, otherwise this is very simple only. So optical rotation. Based on the optical rotation, we can differentiate the sugar's name into L and also D. Okay, plus D means plus clockwise, L means levo, minus anticlockwise. Okay, so the rotation here, it is left side, here, right side. Okay, chiral carbon, we know very well, center of carbon, chiral carbon. Okay. And the chiral carbon, it contains asymmetry and also symmetry compounds. Like if so, it does not contain the same compounds. You see here the chiral carbon, center of the carbon contains here the carbon which is attached with the oxygen and also hydrogen. Here one with this, I mean the center of our chiral carbon contains one valency is over with this compound, another one valency is hydrogen atom, third valency is with hydroxyl, fourth CH2OH. So this is asymmetry because no same compounds present surrounding to our chiral carbon. So it is called as asymmetry. Next. And L isomers of monosaccharide, we know very well what's the meaning of isomer. So, stereoisomer structure, you see the structure. This alpha glucose, D glucose. This is L, this is galactose, okay. This is ribose, okay. So how could you tell this is glucose, no, this is ribose, this is galactose? So you leave other things like this is glucose or mannose or allose. You don't think. So here, how many carbons are there? Six carbon. What is the functional group? Aldehyde. Okay, so this is aldohexose. Okay, come here. How many carbons are there? Five. Right. What's the functional group? Aldehyde. So this is aldopentane. So come to our last carbons are there. Okay. Functional group is aldehyde. So this is aldohexose. Okay. So these two are aldohexose. One is aldopentose. Okay, right. What's the difference between these two aldohexose? How we can differentiate based on its structure? Okay. So see, any difference is there? No differences. Yes, difference is there. What's the difference? Position of hydroxyl atom. Where it is present? In the glucose, left side hydroxyl group is present. Okay. In galactose, left side. No, actually, you leave that D form and L form, like you don't think. Okay, just leave that D and L. You imagine it is also D. Okay, this is not L galactose. This is also D galactose. D glucose and D galactose, like you just imagine. Okay. So, if you write in the fourth carbon, left side hydroxyl group and right side H. Okay, I ask you people, when you write the glucose, how do you write the glucose? Glucose structure, you should be familiar, because it only comes again and again. Okay, glucose on like, right? That is very important also for our glycolysis. Wherever you go to that metabolism, okay, glucose is very important. So glucose structure you should get familiar. So first carbon aldehyde, second carbon left side hydrogen, right side OH, third carbon left side hydroxyl, right side hydrogen atom, fourth carbon contains its left side hydrogen in its right side hydroxyl, fifth carbon also contains the same like in its left side hydrogen atom and right side hydroxyl atom. So the last one CH2OH. So if you write like this, in the sense that sugar is glucose, okay, right? Like the same, you people maximum using pencil only, no? When we people draw the structure, okay. So next you people draw the same structure like our glucose, okay, and use the eraser in the fourth carbon, okay. So in the fourth carbon, what you people are going to write in the left side, you have to write the same hydroxyl group and the right side hydrogen atom. Okay, what I ask you people, you write the same glucose structure. Okay, you just do one alteration here, where in this fourth carbon. Okay, what you people altered? Left side hydroxyl group, right side hydrogen atom. Okay, so what is the sugar now? Okay, the sugar. Left side, I mean third carbon and also fourth carbon left side OH. Okay, third carbon and also fourth carbon right side H. The sugar is called as galactose. Okay, so the difference, structural difference between glucose and galactose is third carbon and also fourth carbon. Okay, others are same. First carbon, what it is present, same present in our galactose also, second also same, fifth also same, sixth also same. Okay, the difference between third and fourth only, right? So third OH left side, fourth also OH left side. So if you draw like this, in the sense that is called as galactose. Okay, okay. So now you come here, what happened? I told you people, you imagine for D galactose. Okay, so if you people draw what I told you, like that same, if you draw in the sense that is D galactose. But what happened here in the L galactose, you just listen. The compounds which are present in the right side, all those compounds present in the left side. Okay, so what are the compounds present in the left side? Those are present in the right side. But why it is not same? Because this is glucose, this is galactose. Okay, so as my advice, if you write the structure in the sense, you can find the difference now. Right, I told you people, third carbon and fourth carbon contain in its which position? Left side. Okay, here present in right side, because the compound name is L galactose. Okay, so if it is D galactose, in the sense, just think the hydroxyl group which are present in the third and also fourth, you have to write in the left side. Okay, so that is D galactose, but it is opposite, no? Because this is L galactose. Okay, left side rotation, right? So this is actually, we people can differentiate what is the form. Is it in the D form or L form? So what you people know, commonly you people very clear in the basic structure. What is the structure of galactose? What is the structure of mannose? What is the structure of glucose? Like, I mean, in the D form, okay? D form, they will give commonly in every books, okay? So L form, you have to change just to the right side and also left side if you change in the sense. Right side, whatever come in the D form, you have to write in the left side in L form. Okay, that's all. So that is D and also L sugar. Okay, position must be changed. Ribose sugar, this is, I already told you, ribose is very familiar sugar, 5-carbon containing pentose sugar. Okay, see, first carbon, second, third, fourth, and fifth, 5-carbon. Okay, functional group is aldehyde. Okay, so primary alcohol. You see, every sugar primary alcohols are there, right? Okay, primary alcohol. So this is aldopentose. Okay, so this is normal. Okay, hydrogen which are present in its left side. No hydroxyl group which is present in left side. Okay, all hydrogen group you should write in the left side. Okay, all hydroxyl group present in the right side, you should write in the right side. Okay, so this is called as D-ribose. Okay, you just imagine if I write all this OH group in the left side, all the hydrogen group, hydrogen atoms in the right side, in the sense, that is called as what? L-ribose. Okay, because rotated, no? Right? So this is L-ribose. Next. Come next, please. Not all carbohydrates exist in equilibrium. Yes, of course. Okay. So with the 6-membered hemiacetal rings. So what do you mean by hemiacetal ring? Hemiacetal. We mostly use the term functional group, maybe aldehyde or ketone. Okay, every sugar. Okay, sugar in the sense, it must contain aldehyde or ketone. So that is sugar. If both are not present in the sense, that is not sugar. Okay, in the compound, if there is no aldehyde, there is no ketose group. Okay, that is ketone group. So that is called as, it's not a sugar. Okay. So at the same time, the sugar contains hemiacetal. Okay, the group. What is this? So we know very well, if you oxidize alcohol, oxidation reaction, what happened to our alcohol? Alcohol oxidized into aldehyde. Okay. If you further oxidize the aldehyde, okay, so our product of our aldehyde further involved in the reaction of oxidation. So what we can get? We can get acid. Okay. So when our alcohol getting oxidized, we can get automatically aldehyde. Okay. So further oxidation, we can get acid. Okay. So this is normal. We know in our chemistry. Right. Here what happened? That is hemiacetal. Okay. Alcohol not oxidized into our full form. So that means alcohol goes to aldehyde, goes to acid, I told you, know. Okay, so our aldehyde, CHO, only our functional group, okay, it getting oxidized. So oxidized into, what's the form? CHOH. The structure which is present in the previous slide, I don't know. Shivam, please help me. CHOH, the first carbon. There is no aldehyde only present here. Okay, HOH, like if the carbon, first carbon before previous slide, no? No. Okay, then it will come the next slides maybe. Okay dear, we move forward. I can find later. Okay, my dear students, CHO, like you people writing now. Okay, so when you people draw into glycosidic linkage formation, that time you have to write CHOH in the first carbon. You have to write CHOH. that is called as hemiacetal form. So what do you mean in the sense? Half of the reaction only completed. Okay, so the compound also getting half oxidized condition. Okay, so the aldehyde not completely oxidized into acid. Okay, so and also not completely reduced into alcohol. So that is called as CHOH. Okay, so this is called as hemiacetal form. We will see that structure in our next slide. Okay, don't worry. If the monosaccharide ring is 6-member, yes, we already discussed before. So the next, tell me next. Sorry, you next. Cyclic structure of monosaccharides. You see, okay. So based on my suggestion, you could understand this. You have to start the cyclic structure. This is pyranose or furanose form, my dear students. This is pyranose or furanose form. This is pyranose form. Okay, so you have to start. I already told you, you should not forget. In the cycle, in this cycle, you have to use only 5 carbon. Okay, 6th carbon you should write here. Okay, so you have to connect with this 5th carbon, and the 6th carbon must be there, right? So see, 1st carbon, this is 1st carbon, this is 2nd carbon, this is 3rd, this is 4th, this is 5th, 6th. Okay, so in it glycosidic form, the first carbon linked with that 5th carbon through our oxygen atom. Okay, so 1st carbon linked with that 5th carbon through oxygen atom, so the 6th carbon is there. Okay, so who found this structure, cycle structure? Haworth. Okay, this is Haworth formula. Okay, so Fischer formula easy, ma'am. Haworth formula, in the sense, Haworth formula only we can draw the disaccharide used for drawing our disaccharide, oligosaccharide as well as our polysaccharide. Okay, so our Haworth formula is must follow, right? So why, ma'am, they mention hydroxyl group here and this here hydroxyl group there? Okay, what is the compound name? So this is glucose. Okay, I told you people, this is glucose. So I again mention, this is D-glucose. Okay, and no, this is D-glucose also, right? And also this is alpha or beta. Yeah. Okay, I have to mention that one, right? So what do you mean by alpha? Alpha D sugar, beta sugar. Okay, what is that next? Okay, alpha, beta. How we can find? How why the hydroxyl group come here? Okay, so we have to write. What is, I mean, remember that glucose structure, 3rd carbon contains hydroxyl group in its left side or right side in glucose? Left side, no? So see here, 1st carbon in the glucose structure. Okay, if you draw in your notebook now, clearly you can write. 1st carbon contains the hydroxyl group in the right side. Hydroxyl group which is present in the right side. So in 2nd carbon also right side. In 3rd carbon hydroxyl group present left side. In 4th carbon also right side. Okay, so right side group you have to write in the bottom. Okay, all the compound or atom or group which is present in the left side, you have to write in the upper part. Okay, so that's why here for hydroxyl group. Okay, so this is alpha or beta form. Alpha form, you have to write the hydroxyl group in the right side. Okay, so beta form, the 1st carbon containing the hydroxyl group which should be come into the left side. Okay, so we people told you have to write all the left side groups in the upper form, upper part. Okay, right side in the lower part. So this is alpha or beta hydroxyl group which is present here, lower part. Alpha or beta, anyone unmute and answer me. for all four sugar hydroxyl group present in the right side. Okay, for beta sugar hydroxyl group present in the left side. Okay, so I already mentioned you people, all the right side groups you should write in the flower pot. Okay, all the left side groups you should write in the upper pot. Okay, so this sugar alpha or beta, next. Okay, we will discuss by using some more slides. You can come to confirmation. What happened, Shivam?
That's all for today's session. It has crossed 50 minutes of class. There is so many slides left. Ma'am will explain all the slides in the next coming classes. So if you have any questions, you can ask students now.
May I ask to students? Students, you may ask me if you have any doubt.
Students will ask you, ma'am, their doubts, their end questions, their queries.
Yeah, okay. Please unmute. Anupriya, Shivali, Suniji, Bhavani, Sweta, Jansi, Alohi, Raju, Yadav, anyone, please ask me.
If you have any questions, students, please come and ask. Regarding today's session, please come and ask if you have any questions. Our regular attendees, please come and ask.
Yes, Shivam, you may ask them. Okay, you send me out. Okay, and then you may ask them whether I'm going very speed. Like, you may ask their suggestion and I will correct. Because I don't know these students, no. I didn't see them. I don't know about them. So if they feel
okay, ma'am.
Inconvenient in the sense, you just inform me.
Yeah, ma'am. Definitely.
Okay, my dear students. You please, we are teaching for you people only. Okay, you may ask, you may give your suggestion to coordinators. Okay, so after that, I can teach you how you people expect, like the same, right? But you people study well. That is the motto.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for this informative session, ma'am.
Okay, dear. Okay, all study well. Bye. May I go?
Yes, ma'am. You can leave the meeting.
Yes.
So, participants, I just want to share some information with you. We have completed 1 month of the session online classes, and every day when we are conducting Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday, only 20 to 25 people are attending these days. So we are not getting that much of spirit to conduct classes. So I request everyone to please be regular. We have more than 180 students, those who registered, but only few students are attending classes. That's not fair, students. Those who are our regular attendees, those who are literally interested in these classes, they are attending. But what about them, those who registered? If you can share this bio setup online classes, how to join and all to others, to with your friends, you can share with your friends also. And if it goes like this, only few people will attend. So we will stop conducting all these classes, because it is not pretty. So I request everyone to please be regular. Only 10 to 20 members are attending classes. And you know how we are, you don't know how we are organizing all the teachers, how they are making PowerPoints. But you people are only few are attending, only few are supporting us. So I request our organizer Mr. Amit to please put the attendance link in the comment
section. Wait, Shivam, Amit, abhi nahi dalna attendance form. Suno Shivam, abhi main abhi check kiya, screenshot liya hu, theek hai. Maximum abhi visible hua hai, seen hua hai tumhara 120, theek hai. 120 mein main screenshot le liya hu. और अभी अमित तुम्हारा काम है सबको ग्रुप से रिमूव करने का, क्योंकि हम ऐसे कंटिन्यू नहीं कर सकते क्लास. ट्वेंटी स्टूडेंट्स है जहाँ पे मैं नोटिस कर रहा हूँ, शिवाली कोल्ला अभी थोड़ा देर पहले ज्वाइन की और एक स्टूडेंट कॉलर 7 अभी तुरंत ज्वाइन की. ऐसे नहीं हो सकता है.
Okay, we will manage that.
I request everyone, please one by one, it's a humble request to you, please unmute your mic and say your feedback. What is the problem you are facing now? Now, Jayanti, please you unmute your mic and say something about what is the problem.
Hello sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, I have no problem, sir.